जय राधा माधव कुंज। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, यशोदा नंदन जन रंजन, शोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तीर वनचारी, उना तीर वनचारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय श्री श्री राधा माधव की जय, श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय, जय जय श्री चैतन्य, जय नित्यानंद, जय अद्वैत चंद्र, जय गौर भक्त वृंद, जय जय श्री चैतन्य, जय नित्यानंद, जय अद्वैत चंद्र, जय गौर भक्त वृंद, जय जय श्री चैतन्य, जय नित्यानंद, जय अद्वैत चंद्र, जय गौर भक्त वृंद। टुडे वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्री चैतन्य चरितामृत आदि लीला चैप्टर 10, द ब्रांचेस ऑफ द चैतन्य ट्री, वर्स नंबर 8। श्रीवास पंडित आर श्री राम पंडित, दुई भाई दुई शाखा जगते विदित। ट्रांसलेशन एंड परपोर्ट बाय श्रील प्रभुपाद। द टू ब्रदर्स श्रीवास पंडित एंड श्री राम पंडित स्टार्टेड टू ब्रांचेस दैट आर वेल नोन इन द वर्ल्ड। Purport. In the Gaur Ganodesh Deepika 90, Srivas Pandit is described as an incarnation of Narad Muni, and Sri Ram Pandit, his younger brother, is said to be an incarnation of Parvat Muni, a great friend of Naradas. Srivas Pandit's wife Malini is celebrated as an incarnation of the nurse Ambika, who fed Lord Krishna with her breast milk. And as already noted, his niece Narayani, the mother of Thakur Brindavan Das, the author of Sri Chaitanya Bhagavat, was the sister of Ambika in Krishna Leela. We also understand from the description of Sri Chaitanya Bhagavat that after Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's acceptance of the sannyas order, Srivas Pandit left Navadip, possibly because of feelings of separation, and domiciled at Kumar Hatta. Om Agyantimirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshu Unmilitam Yena Tasmay Shri Gurave Nama नमः ओम विष्णु पदाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी इति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। सो वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्री चैतन्य चरितामृत चैप्टर 10 वर्स नंबर 8 ट्रांसलेशन। द टू ब्रदर्स श्रीवास पंडित एंड श्री राम पंडित स्टार्टेड टू ब्रांचेस दैट आर वेल नोन इन द वर्ल्ड। आई रीड फ्यू मोर वर्सेस। श्रीपति श्रीनिधि तार दुई सहोदर चारि भैर दास दासी ग्रह परिकर। देयर टू ब्रदर्स वेर नेम श्रीपति एंड श्रीनिधि। दिस फोर ब्रदर्स एंड देयर सर्वेंट्स एंड मेड सर्वेंट्स आर कंसिडर्ड वन बिग ब्रांच। चारि भाई सवंशे करे चैतन्येर सेवा गौर चंद्र विना नाही जाने देवी देवा। There is no counting the sub branches of these two branches. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu held congregational chanting daily at the house of Srivas Pandit. These four brothers and their family members fully engaged in the service of Lord Chaitanya. They knew no other god or goddesses. Hare Krishna. So after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu received initiation from his spiritual master Sripad Ishwarpuri, he was a changed person and he returned to Mayapur Navadvip. Now no longer he was interested in teaching material knowledge or grammar or logic or such subjects. He would just be inclined to chant the holy name of Krishna and he would explain all the philosophical points and grammatical points through the holy name of Krishna, and he will encourage his students to also practice the chanting of Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So all the devotees in Navadvip, when they saw such a transformation, they were very pleased. अद्वैत आचार्य हरिदास ठाकुर श्रीवास पंडित रमाई पंडित श्रीपति श्रीनिधि चंद्रशेखर आचार्य गदाधर पंडित मुरारी गुप्ता मुकुंद संजय श्रीधर शुक्लंबर एंड देर आर सो मेनी डिवोटीज हु वेर अट्रैक्टेड टू चैतन्य महाप्रभु एंड व्हेन दे सॉ चैतन्य महाप्रभु हैज बिकम अ डिवोटी नाउ दे वेर वेरी प्लीज्ड। And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came in the assembly of the devotees and they all started doing kirtan, they saw Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's body manifested ecstatic symptoms of love of Krishna, Krishna Prem, love of Godhead. Tears will come from his eyes, his hairs would stand, his voice will choke up, his body will tremble and perspire, and his bodily color will change and he will shiver, sometimes he will laugh, sometimes he will cry, and he will dance and he will jump up and fall down, and so much amazing ecstatic symptoms, wonderful ecstatic symptoms. And the Vaishnavas were very happy. Whole day they would do kirtan. So one day in the evening after nice kirtan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told to assemble devotees, "We are wasting our time." All the devotees were surprised. Just now we finished nice kirtan, and now Lord is saying we are wasting our time. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said again, "We are wasting our time. We are sleeping at night. वी शुड डू कीर्तन एट नाइट ऑल्सो, नॉट ओनली इन डे टाइम, वी शुड चैंट एंड डांस एट नाइट ऑल्सो. सो ऑल द वैष्णवा सेड हरी बोल, दे वेर वेरी हैप्पी. सो नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज वेयर वी विल डू इट. सो श्रीवास पंडित ओपन हिज हाउस, सेड इन माई हाउस ऑल द डिवोटीज कैन कम एंड होल नाइट वी विल डू कीर्तन चैंटिंग एंड डांसिंग. एंड होल नाइट इन श्रीवास आंगन दे वुड चैंट एंड डांस. चैतन्य महाप्रभु विथ स्लेंडर टॉल ब्यूटिफुल गोल्डन बॉडी एंड नित्यानंद प्रभु एंड अद्वैत आचार्य एंड गदाधर पंडित एंड श्रीवास पंडित एंड हिज ब्रदर्स रमई पंडित एंड हरिदास ठाकुर एंड श्रीधर एंड शुक्लंबर एंड मुरारी गुप्ता एंड मुकुंद संजय एंड चंद्रशेखर आचार्य क्लोज एसोसिएट्स ऑफ चैतन्य महाप्रभु होल नाइट दे वुड चैंट एंड डांस. And sometimes Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will jump so high and he will fall down making such a big sound that devotees would be afraid his bones are broken. And sometimes he will cry loudly and sometimes he will laugh and at times he will fall unconscious and Nityan Prabhu will pick up his transcendental body and remove all the dust and make arrangements so that he becomes conscious and Nityanand Prabhu will dance and Haridas Thakur will dance and Srivas will dance and Gadadhar will dance and Advait Acharya will dance and that was amazing. Srivas Angan, they will close the doors, public was not allowed, nobody was allowed, this was private affair and whole night they would chant and dance. So one such night when the kirtan was just going on, some sound came from inner room, ladies' room. Srivas wife is there and Srivas brother's wife is there, wives are there and Srivas mother is there. So there are family members. Srivas had sons also. So some sound came from inner chamber, inner room. So Srivas Pandit went to see what is happening. That sound will disturb the kirtan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So he went inside and saw his wife is crying, his mother is crying, his babis are crying. Why they are crying? Because Srivas, one of the son, died. The dead body was on the bed. And all the ladies are crying. The mother of the boy is crying. It's natural for them to cry. Srivas Pandit saw the dead body of his son who has just died. Then he told the ladies, shh, don't cry. By your loud crying, the sound is coming out. And that will disturb Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's kirtan. Don't cry. Don't lament. What is the use of crying? This dead body is not your son. That is material attachment. That is material temporary relationship. Our eternal relationship is with Krishna. Our eternal duty is to serve Krishna. And that same Krishna in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is dancing in our house, chanting the holy names. And we should be happy that we are getting an opportunity in our house to serve the Lord and His devotees. Those householders, those grihasthas who open the doors of their house and allow devotees to come and chant and dance and do kirtan and preach and give classes and feed devotees, they are very great householders. That's very great service they are doing. We sadhus or brahmacharis or sannyasis, we may go house to preach. But if there is no house, open for us, how will we preach? Of course, we can go and preach under a tree, but nobody will come to attend the class under a tree. So that is great service done by householders. So Srivas Pandit said, we are very fortunate that we got an opportunity to host Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityanand Prabhu and all the great devotees. So don't cry. We are not supposed to lament for any material loss. Our eternal profit and our eternal benefit is in service of Krishna. And for Krishna's pleasure, not even one son. If all my sons die, that is okay. If I have 100 sons who are needed to die for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pleasure, that is fine. So don't disturb Kirtan, don't cry. And if I hear one more sound from this room, I will go and commit suicide. Srivas Pandit told to his wife and mother and babis and wives of his brothers. Now, is it easy to tell the mother of a dead son, don't cry? And is it easy for that mother to keep quiet? But devotional service is more important. And the ladies kept quiet. And Srivas came back to the courtyard. And again he started dancing in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's kirtan. And as the kirtan was going on, suddenly Chaitanya Mahaprabhu stopped the kirtan. And he said, Srivas, today I am not feeling usual ecstasy. Has something inauspicious happened in this house? Srivas Pandit folded his hand. He said, my dear Mahaprabhu, how can anything inauspicious happen in the house when you are present, when you are chanting and dancing? Nothing inauspicious has happened. Let us continue. And again the kirtan started. After a few hours, again Chaitanya Mahaprabhu stopped the kirtan. He said, Srivas, I am not feeling usual ecstasy. Something inauspicious has happened. Shiva said, no, nothing has happened. Let's do kirtan. Let's dance. But some devotees who have come to know, they went and whispered to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his ears that Shiva's son died. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was surprised. He said, Srivas, when did your son die? He said, my dear Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 9 hours before. He said, 9 hours before your son died and you didn't tell me. Why didn't you stop us? Srivas Pandit folded his hand. He said, my dear Lord, I didn't want to disturb your kirtan. Your kirtan is more important. Your chanting and dancing is more important. What to speak about one son? If all my sons die, no problem. But I want you to happily engage in chanting and dancing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had tears in his eyes, hearing Shiva's surrender, hearing Shiva's affection and love for him. He said, Srivas, where is the dead body? And Srivas took Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to the inside room. There was dead body of the boy on the bed and all the ladies there. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made the dead son alive. He touched him and he became alive. Everybody was surprised. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, my dear boy, where did you go? Why did you leave the house of Srivas? Look, your mother is crying. Why you're giving them suffering and pain? So the soul spoke. And the soul said, my dear Lord, I am your eternal servant. But somehow I have fallen down in this material existence. And since millions of births, I have been changing families. And as per my karma, I stay in one family for a particular duration of life. And then I go to next birth, next family. Like this, I am continuing in the cycle of birth and death. So I don't know who is my father and who is my mother, because I had millions of fathers and millions of mothers. And as per my karma, I came in Srivas Pandit's house. And once my duration of life was supposed to be finished by your order, I left this place. But this time, my dear Lord, I was so fortunate that when I was in this body, a son of Srivas Pandit, I got to touch your feet. I got to pay you obeisances. I got to see your beautiful form. I took your darshan. I saw your chanting and dancing. And while Kirtan was going on, I was hearing the holy name of Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And I left this body and I got liberated. My dear Lord, after millions of births, today I got an opportunity to get liberated because I heard the holy name and you were present in this house. It is all your mercy, my dear Lord. And the soul again left the body. And all the devotees were surprised and amazed. And the ladies were amazed. And Srivas Pandit was amazed that my son got liberated. Then the other sons of Srivas, they came and touched the feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that our brother has got liberated. And we want the same fortune, that we leave our body in your presence, that we leave our body when we are hearing the holy name and you are chanting and dancing in our house. That is the success of this life, that we go back home, back to Godhead. If we do lots of activities and perform lots of work in this human form of life using our intelligence, skills and talents, we earn lots of money, we become big leader and we get good reputation and we get good image in the society and people appreciate us and people follow us and we own a big house and we own a big company and we own a big car and many big family members and children and grandchildren and wife and everything successful and everything great, and next life we become a dog. Is there any use? It's completely third class. Next life I become a dog, or I become a cat, or I become a donkey, or I become a monkey, or a bird, or a fish, or a tree, or a snake, or a mosquito, or coronavirus. What is the use of this? No use. The success of human form of life is not to get some material achievement, which is temporary, which will put us into entanglement in hellish planets and lower species birth. The success of human form of life is to go back home, back to Godhead. And that's only possible by pure devotional service. Only possible by surrendering to Krishna. 100% devotional service. No, there is no other way. So the brothers of the dead body, the son who departed, they touched the feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and they were praying for the same fortune. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, let's do the funeral. And he personally helped in the funeral and he carried the body of Srivas' son and they went to the Ganges. And that is how they did the funeral at Ganga Ghat. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu loved Srivas and his family so much. Srivas was so fortunate that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would stay in his house and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would chant and dance and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would be merciful to everybody in Srivas' house. Not just Srivas Pandit and his wife Malini Devi, not just Srivas' brothers and their wives and family and children. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would be merciful to Srivas' servants, Srivas' watchmen, Srivas' visitors, Srivas' house cockroaches and mosquitoes and rats and ants and insects. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu liberated everybody. There was a Muslim tailor who used to eat meat and he used to sew the clothes for Srivas' house. So one day that Muslim terror was running in the streets of Navadeep like a madman and screaming, "I have seen, I have seen, I have seen," raising his hands, "I have seen, I have seen, I have seen." So some people stopped him, said, "Hey, pagal, madman, why are you running and shouting?" He said, "I have seen, I have seen." He said, "What you have seen?" He said, "I have seen, I have seen." And he started running. Another friend caught him. He said, "Hey, what happened? What have you seen?" And he replied, "I have seen, I have seen." He was a mad person, acting like a mad person. Now, what had happened is, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to the house of Srivas. At the gate, he saw this tailor. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked him, "Who are you?" He said, "I am a tailor and I sew clothes of Srivas and I just delivered some clothes and I am going back now." Chaitanya said, "You are Srivas tailor, Srivas Darji?" Immediately Chaitanya Mahaprabhu showed his beautiful Shyam Sundar form holding a flute and a peacock feather, blackish body, yellow dhoti, Vaijanti garland. He just gave his darshan as two-handed Krishna Shyam Sundar form to the tailor. Why? Because tailor did chanting 16 rounds? No. Because tailor did bhakti? No. But because tailor served Srivas. And seeing Shyam Sundar form, the tailor became so ecstatic in love. He developed Krishna prem and he became mad and he started running all over Navadvip saying, "I have seen, I have seen, I have seen." So any person who serves Srivas becomes more dear to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu than his own servant. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is more merciful to the servant of Srivas than his own servant because Srivas is so dear to him. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to do his nightly kirtans, nocturnal kirtans at the house of Srivas, he would not allow anybody else to come inside. They would close the door and lock it from inside. But the sound of kirtan would go outside and people knew that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is doing kirtan and dancing. So many pious people in Navadvip wanted to see the kirtan. So they would approach Srivas. He said, "I hear Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dances in your house every day night. I want to see that dancing. Can I come?" But Srivas Pandit said, "No, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has not allowed. He has denied entry to anyone, so nobody can come." So many devotees wanted to come, but they were not allowed. There was one Brahmana Brahmachari in Navadvip who never ate grains, never ate rice, only fruits and milk. Mostly milk he would take, sometimes fruits he will take. Very austere, pure Brahmana, simple Brahmana. So this pure Brahmana Brahmachari, he approached Srivas Pandit. He said, "Look, I want to see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu doing kirtan and dancing. Can you please allow me?" Srivas Pandit said, "My dear Brahmachari, I can't allow you." Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has said no. He said, "Look, I am a very pure person. I take only milk and fruits. I don't eat grains and be away from women. Please allow me." So repeatedly he requested. So finally finally Srivas Pandit said, "Okay, I will allow you. But please know that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would not like it. So you cannot be visible. You have to hide. You hide whole night inside my house and from hidden place you see the kirtan. You come before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu arrives and you go after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu departs." So the Brahmachari said, "Okay." So the Brahmachari hid behind the curtain in the evening. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu and all other devotees came and they started doing kirtan. And after 2-3 hours, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu stopped the kirtan. He said, "Srivas, I am not feeling usual ecstasy. There is somebody in this house who is not supposed to be here." Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Paramatma. He knows everything, super soul. And Srivas understood, "I can't hide more." So he just paid obeisances to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, folded his hands and said, "My dear Lord, one pure Brahmachari is here. He repeatedly requested me. He wanted to see you dance. And he is very simple brahmachari. He drinks only milk and he is celibate. So I allowed him. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very furious and he raised his voice. He said, what do you think, Shriva? Just by drinking milk he can conquer me? Just by drinking milk he can control me? Just by drinking milk he can get Krishna prem? That's not possible. Krishna's mercy is available only by pure devotional service, not by drinking milk or not by performing austerities. Even if somebody is a sannyasi and very austere, but if he is not acting as a servant of Krishna, he will not get Krishna prem. And somebody is a chandala, dog eater, but if he is surrendered to Krishna, he will get Krishna prem. So tell him to come here and get out from here. And she was brought that brahmachari who was feeling very ashamed, and he paid obeisances and he left. He didn't speak anything. While going, he thought that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is so merciful, he chastised me. And he chastised me so that I can improve in my life. That's humility. To accept chastisement positively is humility. And he was feeling happy that some dance I saw. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu knew his heart. He immediately called him. He said, you have developed humility. That is qualification for entry into Krishna Bhakti. And today I give you Krishna Prem. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu put his feet on his head. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught him a lesson that even if somebody is austere, drinking only milk or eating only fruits or fasting nirjal, one should not be proud of his austerity. Somebody may chant more rounds, but if he becomes proud that I am chanting more rounds, then that pride is against Krishna consciousness. Somebody may do nice service, may lead nice kirtan or do nice cooking or give nice classes, and he becomes proud, then that is all in vain. So one should not become proud. One should not think that I am greater than others, I am better than others. One should understand whatever performance I am doing is by Krishna's mercy. Whatever success is coming, Krishna is supposed to take the credit. It all belongs to him, not to me. Whether nice kirtan or nice class or memorizing shlokas or playing mridang kartal or cooking or deity worship or anything, it's all Krishna. Because of empowerment of Krishna, this is happening. I am just a nimitta, just an instrument, and I should just serve Krishna as a servant of servant of servant of Krishna. Nothing belongs to me. So the brahmachari got a lesson, and we should learn that without humility we cannot advance in bhakti. Trinad api sunichena taror eva shaishuna amanina manadena kirtaniya sada hari. We have to be as humble as a straw in the street and as tolerant as a tree, giving respect to others and not expecting any respect for ourselves. Then we can practice Krishna consciousness 24 hours, which is the ultimate goal of life, which is the ultimate purpose of life, which is the ultimate success of life. So we have to give up this pride and embrace humility and become servant of servant of servant of Krishna. We should find a devotee whom we become servant, willingly surrender and serve, and that will help us to advance in bhakti. So we learn a very important lesson. And Srivas Pandit whole day would serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So once Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was in at the house of Advaita Acharya, from there he came to the house of Srivas Pandit. And he stayed there few days, and Srivas Pandit whole day served him. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu once in private called Srivas Pandit and said, I want to speak you. We speak to you. So Srivas Pandit folded his hands and said, yes, my dear Lord. He said, I see whole day you are at house. You don't go out for earning. You don't have any source of income. You don't do job. You don't have business. You don't have investment. and you have such a big family to feed. How you are feeding your family without income? How this is happening? Srivaspanda said, my dear Lord, whatever comes by its own, I accept. And that is sufficient. I don't have to go out and work. Shiva said, that's like a sannyasi. You are a grahastha. A grahastha is supposed to earn. Grahastha cannot get money without working. So you should do something. Srivas Pandit said, my dear Lord, I have a very simple formula. Chaitanya said, what is that formula? Srivas Pandit said, my formula is this. 1, 2, 3. He clapped 3 times. He said, I have 1, 2, 3 formula. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not understand. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, what is the meaning of this 1, 2, 3? Why are you clapping like this? Somebody was telling me today in corporate world, also they have this formula. 1, 2, 3. What companies do is they hire one person and they give him salary of 2. So the person is very happy. Generally, when you go from one company to another company, they give you 40% hike, 50% hike. So you are very happy that my previous company didn't give me so much money, my new company is giving me. But then they gave him work of 3 people. That means they remove 3 people, and out of the work of 3 people, they hire 1 person and give him salary of 2 and work of 3. 1, 2, 3. That is called exploitation today in the business. So Srivas Pandit has a different formula. He said, my dear Lord, one day I will see if the food doesn't come. Second day, I will see if the food doesn't come. Third day, if the food doesn't come, I will jump in Ganga and commit suicide. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard this, he stood up very furious and angry. He said, Srivas, you will commit suicide even if Lakshmi Devi has to beg. Even if Lakshmi Devi has to take a bowl and beg all over the village, I will make sure there is sufficient in your house. Even if there is recession in Vaikuntha, even if Lakshmi Devi and Vishnu goes bankrupt, still I will make sure, Shriva, there is sufficient in your house for you and your family, because you are very dear to me. So Srivas Pandit has such a faith in Krishna. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself, loves Srivas Pandit so much. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu quoted the words from Bhagavad Gita saying that my pure devotees are completely depend on me. What they have, I preserve. And what they lack, I provide. So what you have, Krishna is not going to take away. He will protect and keep it with you. And what you don't have, Krishna is going to provide. So we don't have to worry, we just have to serve him. He is our eternal master, he is our eternal maintainer, and he is already maintaining us. Whatever we need for the body, water, food grains, vegetables, fruits, air, is provided by Krishna, not by some factory. There is no factory which can make even a single grain of rice. All this is provided by Krishna. By Mother Nature, by Krishna's mercy, by sunlight, by rain, by earth, by seeds, everything is provided. So Krishna is already feeding us, Krishna is already maintaining us, Krishna is already taking care of us. Isn't it our duty to reciprocate with his love by providing him service with love? He is loving us, so we should love him. That is eternal, constitutional, natural relationship. That Krishna loves me and I love him. And our love to Krishna is expressed by service. So we should serve Krishna. And in this material world, a conditioned soul practices sadhana to develop this love. And once he develops pure love for Krishna, in spiritual body, in the spiritual world, Golok Vrindavan, he eternally serves Krishna. And that's life. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was so happy with Srivas. One more time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he called Srivas in private. He said, I want to speak to you. At that time, Nityananda Prabhu was staying in Srivas' house. And Nityananda Prabhu was an elderly personality, of course. I mean, adult body. But he would act like a small boy. So much so that he will drink the breast milk of Srivas' wife. Srivas' wife's breasts were dry. But when Nityananda Prabhu touched that breast, milk would overflow and he would drink that milk. And he would be like a small baby. He would roam around naked in the house. And Malini Devi would feed him with his own hands. He would not eat by his hands. And he would take rice and throw all over like small children do. He is Avaduta. He is madman in Krishna Prem. So he would act like a small baby, drinking breast milk, throwing rice and roaming naked. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Srivas, he said, this Nityanand, he is Avaduta. We don't know from what village he has come. We don't know what is his caste. And you don't know who is his family. And you are allowing him to stay in your house. He is drinking breast milk of your wife. And he is roaming naked in your house. What if people come to know about this? Your reputation and your wife's reputation will be finished. They will point finger at your character and your wife's character. Because an adult person is roaming naked in your house, touching the breast of your wife and drinking breast milk and throwing rice and playing like a child. So why you keep Nityanand in your house? Let him go. Srivas told, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Srivas like this. So Srivas Pandit folded his hands and said, my dear Lord, why are you testing me like this? I don't mind if Nityanand walks naked in my house and drinks the milk of my wife or throws rice. Even if Nityanand goes to prostitutes, even if Nityanand goes into the liquor store and drinks, even if Nityanand commits most abominable sinful activity, I will still offer my love and service to Nityanand, allow him to stay in my house. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was surprised. He said, why will you do that? Srivas Pandit said, because he loves you. I don't want to know Nityanand's background, Nityanand's caste, Nityanand's gown, Nityanand's family history, Nityanand's qualities. I don't need to know about his behavior. I just know that he loves you, and that is sufficient qualification for me to serve him, because he loves you. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard this, he was so happy. He said, Srivas, you are my real devotee. And you understand the position of Nityanand. And I am very happy with you. This is dedication. This is surrender. We should not feel bad about Lord Nityanand. He is Avaduta, beyond the rules and regulations. And all this is helping us to understand the character of Srivas Pandit. Srivas Pandit, as mentioned here, is Narad. Sorry. Srivas Pandit is Narad Muni. And his brother Ramaya Pandit is Parvat Muni. And they both have come into serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Narad Muni has come as Srivas Pandit and is one of the Panchatattva. And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu stay there and in Srivas house, he once asked Srivas, who brings water from Ganga for my bathing? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to take bath there in the shower room and somebody would fill the water in the bucket. So he asked, who brings water? So there was one maid servant, her name was Dukhi. So Srivas Pandit said, there is one Mataji, one maid servant, her name is Dukhi. She brings daily water from Ganga for your bath. Chaitanya said, why her name is Dukhi? Her name should be Sukhi. From today you call her Sukhi. And they changed the name. They started calling her Sukhi. Not only is her name changed, actually she became Sukhi. She became happy. Because when you are serving Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when you are serving Krishna, you are happy. There is no Dukkha. Dukkha is only illusion. Dukkha is because of our own mind. Dukkha is because of our own temporary material attachments. In Krishna consciousness, there is no Dukkha. Chant and be happy. Krishna is full of joy. Krishna's holy name is full of joy, full of sweetness. There is no distress in Krishna consciousness. It's our own mind which manifests temporary distress, which is illusory. In service of Krishna, we should always be happy. And we should imbibe this mood of Srivas Pandit, that we should be ready to serve Krishna and his devotees fully, so that more and more preaching mission continues. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission is to preach whole world, and we should help in propagating this mission and chant the holy names of Krishna. Invite people to temple, invite people to our house and feed them prasadam and let them associate with devotees, or invite people to watch online classes nowadays when house programs are not possible in our area, and give books, give prasadam, teach them how to chant holy name, and in that way we perform our duty and please Krishna. That's the ultimate goal of our life. Okay, we will end here. Thank you very much. If there are any questions, you may please type in the comment box. Sri Chaitanya Chaitamrita ki jai, Srivas Pandit ki jai, Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Hare Krishna. Okay, there are no questions. We'll end here. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.